Here we are with part two of Kids Love This and So Will You, brought to you by ginbooks@gmail.com. I thought I would put it in writing so you could remember it. ginbooks@gmail.com. I'm just going to put it right here so that I won't forget it myself. Years ago, my wife and I made a trip to Alaska, and on that 10-day trip, we visited a version of the Eskimo Olympics, they called it. And there I bought a set of Eskimo yo-yos, or you might say this is one set. It's a string, maybe it's almost 30 inches long. And in the middle, they have tied a piece of leather right here. I'm going to hold that up kind of close to the camera so you can see that piece of leather. And then the pom-poms on it are made of moose hide. I guess they're real. They might be fake, and they've got some kind of weight inside, not very heavy, but something is in there like this. And here's what you do. And the funny thing is, there were no instructions with it, but a couple of kids who were like 9 and 11 years old, a brother or sister, showed me how to do it on our trip. You start by swinging the long string, and let's start back over. Note, one is about this much longer than the other, all right? So you swing the long string, what I would call counterclockwise to me, to where I'm looking. And then all of a sudden, you toss the other one up, and then they start going at the same time. Maybe I better pay more of attention to what I'm doing. Here we go. Round and round and round. And now, they're going together. Well, I showed these to children in my Alaska school show, and I told them I thought I'd practice and see if I could do 50 times in a row. Now, let me show you the way this little thing works to help you out. If you want to do this, your hand is just kind of doing like this. You're not swinging all around. Once you get them going, you're just doing not as exaggerated a version as I'm doing, but something along the line to keep them going, and they do. I'm sure there's a YouTube video that'll show you how to do this, but I started by showing the kids, and then I said to the kids in the audience, what if I could do it 50 times? Tell you what, I'll try and you count me out, and if I make it to 50, maybe you could give me a big round of applause. And so I started, and I did like this, and I got him going, and we started counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Oh, I'm sorry. I guess I'm not going to be able to do it today. But you know what? Sometimes I try it again. And sometimes I did the 50. And sometimes I finished up and I just did it for laughs and ended up, if I did the 50, something like this. Oh! And most of the time I did the 50 and the kids gave me a round of applause. And that is the Eskimo yo-yo. It's kind of a skill feat, not exactly hardcore magic. But now this, you might say, is. I like to get a couple of people up to help me. It can be grown-ups, a couple of kids. I've even used this with preschool. But if I do, I tie the ropes ahead in loops ahead of time, because preschoolers don't know how to tie knots. So I tie the blue one with a Boy Scout square knot. Somebody told me one time, he said, well, are you a Boy Scout? I said, well, I'm not now. I was a Boy Scout, but I am an Eagle Scout. There is a difference. So I have three ropes looped like this, and I would borrow, let us say I borrow the green one from this little girl right here, and I take the two just like this. Oh my goodness, would you look what just happened? They're hooked together. Here, I'll say to Billy, this will be Billy and this will be Nancy. So I put these two right here and do this. And the next thing I know, I've got all three linked together. Look, it looks like Mickey Mouse. Or maybe it's ring around the collar. Or hey, it's chain, chain, chain. If you know Aretha Franklin, that was one of her songs. Chain, chain, chain. Anyway, let me see. Nancy is here, and this is Bobby right here. Tell you what, Nancy, I want you to, which color do you have? The red one? Let's pretend she had red. She pulls on the red, and the red comes completely out. I have him pull on the green. It comes off, and ta-da, we're unlinked. Let me show you what's going on here. When I was a 14-year-old, I had the trick called E.J. Moore's linking ropes. It's a great trick, except up close, you could kind of see the gimmick. The gimmick was a magnet glued into the white cotton rope. These ropes are made of wool. They are knitted wool, and they have a very strong magnet, you see right there, in the rope. It's like an earth magnet or something. So that is the gimmick. Now what you do is lay one of these over the rope, over the blue, red over blue, and I'm going to try to get in here close, and then you just pull like this. It comes through the blue, and the blue snaps back together. I'll do it again. I'll lay the green over the blue, switch my finger around, pull, and it goes right through, you see? Goes right through. Now, to get them undone after I've done these designs, and by the way, the whole routine is in Kid Show Magic Compendium, I lay both of them over the hand, switch the finger around again, and pull here, and I move while I'm pulling, because you'd use this big motion of moving to cover up the little motion of them coming unlinked. Once I've done that, I have the children pull them apart, and ta-da, the end. With grown-ups, I have them untie the ropes, and we do a slightly different ending, but it's still, ta-da, the ropes are undone. So that is the color linking ropes. This is an exclusive from David Ginn at Ginnville, because I had these made especially for me, and we have done the last run. We still have some. Remember, ginnbooks@gmail.com. Now, I'm going to move my table over here a little bit, and we're going to talk about a frog who's a green frog. His name is Freddy the Frog, and we're going to have some fun with his story here, Freddy the Little Green Frog, in just a couple of minutes. But you know what? Sometimes I do this. Oh my goodness. Look, everybody. I've got a frog in my throat. There he is. And you know what? This is Freddy the Frog, and he can do his magical disappearing act. Look, I put him behind my back just like this and bring him out. Now, which hand do you think he's in? Boy, what? Of course, little kids will say, he's in that hand over there. No, 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 because the older kids know he's right over. Oh, he's gone. Hold on. Wait a minute. I'm going to look. See. I wonder where he went. And, of course, you turn your back, and the kids see him on your back. Turn again. Look around like this. Kids are yelling and shouting, and you say, I don't know what you're talking about. Let me turn around there and look. And when you look, he's gone because you secretly moved him to the front. Finally, you find him. The kids are happy. I put him on my shoulder and say, let's give him a big round of applause. Here's what's going on. I have a Goshman sponge frog, and look what I've done on the bottom. I put on a piece of rolled up duct tape. Duct tape will hold up even in moisture weather. I don't use the other kinds of tape. So here's your duct tape on the back, and I simply stick him on my back at the right time, stick him on my front, and even on my shoulder. So that is tape with the little green frog, sponge frog. But let me tell you what, there's an old story that goes like this. It's the story of Freddy the Little Green Frog. I'm not going to read the whole thing, but I'm going to give you the gist of the booklet. This came out of a 40s reader book, and it has a story of Freddy the Little Green Frog. And as you read the story, his mother gives him a pair of yellow pants. And then his father decided he needed a blue coat, and grandmother sewed him a red vest. So as you read the story, he keeps putting these clothes on. He's wearing, remember, the yellow pants, the blue coat, and the red vest. And I get the children in my library or school show audience saying those things. Well, in the story, Freddy goes down to the frog pond, or the fish pond, whatever pond. He looks in the water trying to see some of his friends, and he sees a reflection of himself, but he doesn't know that. So he gets all upset because the frog in the water has on yellow pants and a blue coat and red vest. And you keep saying this over and over. All right? Finally, he meets Mr. Turtle, and Mr. Turtle says, Freddy, look in the water again. And remember, we've been using those colors over and over, repeating with the children. Let me read you exactly what it says when you get towards the end of the story. I think you'll like this part. if I can get to it. Mr. Turtle said, cheer up, Freddy. You look fine in your new clothes. The frogs you saw in the water all have faces like yours. Look again and look at their clothes. Freddy looked in the water again. There was another frog. It had on a pair of yellow pants and a blue coat and a red vest. Freddy threw up his hands, and so did the frog in the water. Threw up his hands too. Freddy said, oh no. The frog in the water said, oh no. Then Freddy cried and cried until tears fell out of his eyes and clouded up the water. When tears fell in the water and made it cloudy, the frog in the water disappeared. Then Freddy said, oh no, that's not another frog. That's my face in the water. Those are my yellow pants and my blue coat and my red vest. And Mr. Turtle said, Freddy, the truth is, you did not know how fine you looked in your new clothes. The story of Freddy the Little Green Frog. But there's more. Have you noticed, boys and girls, what we were saying the whole time of reading Freddy's story? We were saying the primary colors over and over. These are the three colors that make up all the other colors. Here, let me show you what I mean. The primary colors are yellow. I can show you with a shoelace. Yellow, and the next one is blue, like his blue coat. And what was the third one? Red, his red vest. And look what I have. Oh my goodness, I wonder where the yellow went. Sounds like a toothpaste commercial. Wait a minute, hold on. Here it is, right in my vest pocket. So you see, we have the three primary colors here in the form of shoelaces. And you know what? Let me see if you boys and girls know what happens. If we mix the colors red and yellow together, what do we get? That's right, we get orange. What if we mix blue and yellow together? What do we get? Green, that's right. Now, here's a harder one. What if we mix red and blue together? Anybody know? That's right, you're right, we get purple. But what if we mix them all together? Look, I've got a little red can here to match Freddy's vest. And here they go in the can. And I'm going to take a lid and put it right on top of the can and give it a shake. One, two, three. And when I take off the top, we don't have a frog. But guess what? We have my friend, ta-da, the magic rabbit right there, showing the primary colors, which are yellow, blue, and red. And that's our story of Freddy the Little Green Frog and a magical appearance by my rabbit. I tell you what, why don't you give Freddy and the rabbit a big round of applause? And they do. Now, this is a routine that I've used in library shows and school shows, and it's just as much fun wherever you are. I start by using a Mary Switch can invented by Richard Mary in England about 60 years ago. It is basically a dove pan. It has a low chamber. And in that load chamber, which is like the top of a dove pan, I take this scarf, and I'm gonna do a quick version right now, put it down in here. I've got a couple of tabs on the top so I can reach and get the top and pull it right out. And once it's inside, I put the lid on. Now, the Mary Switch can comes with a hole in the top. I covered mine with red tape because I want to be able to pick the can up like this and show it empty quickly without putting my thumb in that hole. Now, color-changing shoelaces, I'm not going to describe all the working of this. We have been making color-changing shoelaces here at Genville for 39 years. This is the last year. We have made up all of our supplies, and when they're gone by Christmas, that's the end of David Ginn and the color-changing shoelaces. But you've heard the story of the frog, and we do have five different kinds of color-changing shoelaces. Check on the website, GinnMagic.org, or write me where I told you. Put these inside, show this empty. This goes here, give it a shake, and when you take off the top, you pull out the scarf, whatever you want to produce out of there. The Mary Switch can is great for changing one thing to another or making a production, and I'm going to take a slight break here, but we'll be back with part three, brought to you by genbooks@gmail.com. See you in a few minutes.